off Rhode Island's rocky coast lay the haunts of monster striped bass. Three men on a hunt for 60-pound plus stripers. Two of them try to beat their best, but one of them may have just raised the bar. Up next on Monster Fish.
Whatever it takes. Wherever it takes them. It's a hunt for monster fish. Trev Gabby.
There he goes.
And Fred Levitman.
Come on!
A breed of men dedicated to one thing. Catching the biggest fish on the planet. Tangle with the Titans. On Trev Gowdy's Monster Fish.
It's a time when decent folk are in bed and others are trying to beat last call. But here we smell the dark sea air and hear the casting net striking the water with a sound like a shower of fresh rain.
A lot of bait, about halfway.
Here's the golden key to our waking dreams of 60 or even possibly 70-pound giant stripers. Captain Ken Zwirko, good friend, trophy striper skipper. And that's Ray Martin, who's yet to see a 30-pound bass. And within minutes of the chum hitting the water, the stripers are hitting off Block Island. Over the many years of fishing together, this is the kind of striper action Ken and I have shared. Compare this fish to Ken, who stands 6'4".
What a day. Nice fish. Look at this fish.
Then out of the fog, bait booms.
Oh, there he is. School of fish, school of fish.
School of fish.
Yeah! Kenny! This is a big one. What am I gonna do?
Come on, buddy.
I got two fish on.
We got three fish on here, man.
This guy took a mile of line. I'm shocked that I still have him on.
You can't complain about numbers in action like these, but there's still a dream we have.
This is a very famous area for 50, 60-pound stripers. Over the years, Kenny and I have never caught anything over 60. We got several 50s in the boat, so our goal this year is to help you fire up and get a couple 60-pounders in the boat. We're fishing on several ledges here off of Block Island. We've got about a 23-mile run. We're sitting on top of this ledge right now, 43 feet of water. And what these ledges do, they run for several hundred yards out. And those stripers will be laying off in the deeper water, 80, 90 feet. We take all this fresh bogey that we brought out this morning, chop it up, get a good chum going, get these stripers fired up. So hopefully as we bottom bounce back with our bigger pieces of bogey, we can hook up in some of these fish. First bogey of the day, the season starts.
You told me it was an all-inclusive trip, all you can eat and all you can drink. I just didn't know it was bogeys and salt water. Thanks a lot, Big Spender.
Hey, Ray, you're lucky we even let you do the chumming.
I ate that 2 years ago with Kenny. How's it taste?
Just in season.
Fresh, isn't it?
Absolutely.
Well, just imagine how it's going to taste to a big striper.
In fact, there's an art and a science to chumming that goes beyond sleepless nights casting nets and packing ice chests.
and is lost on most people. The run to Buck Island is a run toward the goal of 60-pound stripers for veterans and novice alike. And we meet and greet competitors for our hard-earned jump.
Hey, beat it! See that damn bird trying to steal my chum?
How you doing up there, bird whisperer?
Good, I'm gonna have a whole flock here in about 5 minutes.
You know, for a lot of years, Kenny and I always just stored our base just on ice, but you had to lay them flat on the ice, very gentle, mainly because you don't want to get the slime off. Now we're doing these big Ziplocs. It keeps all the slime on them, which is so key. Those huge stripers know the difference between half dried out or all fresh slime. So this is why we pack them now, nice and tight, ice, and they're ready to go. Without this, no big fish.
Sink, the rod's bent. But what is on the end of the line may not be what we hope for.
That was fun.
Now we have to fight bluefish over our shrinking supply of bait.
Okay.
Bluefish, huh, Trev?
Look at that bluefish. Watch him.
Most anglers would count this as a good day of fishing. But for us, bluefish are mortal enemies.
Right, Kenny? Bluefish bonanza down there. Go through 50 baits, then you might get that one thump.
Long nights of wearing work all come down to a big box of ice.
Guys, I think we're gonna pack this up. We got 5 to 7 built in here. We're broadside anchored up. That's gonna be a kind of a dangerous situation here the next hour. As this hide starts screaming, we don't wanna get flipped over. All right, hold on, boys.
Back at it. Treading that casting net for a bit, and hard work for peaceful dreams.
60 pounder today, bro.
At it again, buddy.
Now this is bass weather. A little rain, overcast, wind,
swelly.
His chumming work has earned striper novice Ray Martin a spot in the bow, where he's unlikely to catch a thing. Where we had to fight it out with bluefish, we now have a new contender.
Oh,
Now we got dog fish.
Took a nice bite out of that back. What's worse, Trev, loser dog?
I'm going to go with bluefish, because most of the time I can shake my bogey off a dog fish.
They're both tame.
There we go.
This is unquestionably the bite and the run of a striper.
I got one too. I got a bass. What? He slammed me on the way up, Trev.
Cool stuff, man.
Yep. Doubled up, buddy.
Doubled up, bro.
Piano wire. Not good.